Welcome to the Tennis Warehouse Racquet Review with the Tecnifibre TFight DC 320. As the heaviest member of the updated TFight series, the DC 320 offers impressive maneuverability and good power for more experienced players. Dynacore technology improves the stability of the racquet, while the Armor Cap bumper guard system helps protect against wear to the racquet head. First up on the review, we've got Carly, and I know you're typically a big fan of those control-oriented players' frames. This one comes in a little bit heavier than what you're typically used to, though. How did it work out for you?
Well, it's heavier weight, and along with the denser string pattern, I was surprised with how much power it offered. I was expecting a lot more control, given those two aspects of this racket, but I was getting a lot of power all throughout the court. At the baseline, I liked it the most with ground strokes, just because I could get more spin, so I was able to put a lot of topspin on my shots to keep the ball from flying long on me. However, the biggest downside for me was that power, and I thought it had a really erratic sweet spot. It was a really small one, so if I hit outside of it, my shots felt drastically more dead. And then with serves, I just could not find the court with this racket. I just had to really use my second serves, my kick serves, to keep the ball in. But apart from that, I really liked its easy power with the access to spin.
Next up, we've got the always stylish Troy Lara, looking good in the TM cap and polo. How did this racket work out for you?
Well, as Carly mentioned, I was surprised how much pop I was getting off this racket for having an 18 main string pattern. Felt like the ball came off the string bed, especially from the baseline and on serve. It was coming off with good pace. I actually thought this racket did have a good blend of power and control. I think the string pattern helped with the control aspect, so I didn't really have any problems finding my targets, especially from the baseline. Felt like I could put the ball where I wanted to. Probably the biggest downside for me with this racket and even some of the previous Tecnifibres I've tried before is just the lack of feel and response, in my opinion. I guess compared to like the Blade 98 that I've been using, kind of a stiffer feel, kind of has a hollower feel to the frame. Just so like when I came to net or like on touch shots, I just didn't get that really good feedback. But from the baseline and on serve were my favorite places with this racket. I got good spin. I would add a little bit more weight for plow through, but a decent racket, just not the feel I was looking for.
Next up, we've got Michelle, and I know you're typically a fan of that crisper feeling modern player's frame. How did this one work out for you?
Yeah, the RA was perfect for my game because it was a stiffer feeling racket, so I could generate lots of power pretty easily, good depth right off the bat with this racket. Although I did find the sweet spot to feel a little bit small, and the racket to me felt a little brassy, so I didn't love that about it. But other than that, ground strokes were fine. Like Carly mentioned, I really struggled with my serve as well. I just found no consistency, no control out of it. So again, just like what she said, I had to focus on second serves and just really hitting slice or kicks to get my first serve in. At net, I found it to be pretty simple. And again, on returns, it was like my ground strokes. I could pick big targets and go after it and just, you know, was craving a little bit of a bigger sweet spot and a softer feel.
I was also on this playtest, and I really found that easy power that everyone else has mentioned on this playtest already, especially from the baseline. I was a little timid as far as taking a bigger cut at the ball. I was finding that when I took shorter swings and kind of let the racket do the work and generate the power for me, then I was able to find my targets a little bit more. When I took bigger cuts at the ball, I lost a little bit of control. And I also kind of like what Carly alluded to, that sweet spot did feel a little bit small. So when I took a bigger cut at the ball, and I didn't make perfect contact, I thought the feel was really uncomfortable outside of the sweet spot, and there was a big drop off in power. I also experienced similar issues on the serve. I could generate tons of pace. I loved how big I could hit my big flat first serve, but I wasn't finding my target. So I was kind of aiming a little bit closer to the middle of the box in order to be effective. But all in all, a powerful, modern style player's frame with a very crisp feel. If that's what you're looking for, then certainly give this one a try. For this playtest, we had the racket strung up with Solinko Hyper G at 52 pounds. If you want to learn more, be sure to come to tenniswarehouse.com.